Mary Jo has had a motto down through the years: let's keep the magic in Christmas. But more than that, there is a magic. Oh boy, I forgot what that was. There is a magic.
But I lost my thought.
Well, what I wanted to provide for the kids for Christmas was, I suppose, the thing that strikes in my mind sticks in my mind mostly, is the idea that we wanted to have, and I wanted to have, the kids have more than we had. You have to remember that that's the big difference. I lived through as a child depression. And now we had come out of the depression. This was post-war, and the things were more plentiful. Everything that you could imagine was available that was not available, of course, during the wartime and during the depression. So that we wanted our kids, I wanted my kids, to have everything that we could possibly afford to give them.
My very first Christmas was pure magic for me. And I think that I probably engineered our Christmases after the children came along. Based in this magic. Now, I only received two things for that Christmas: a card of Jack's and a long piece of chewing gum. It wasn't bubble gum, it was just a long, flat piece of gum. And because Santa Claus brought it, that was pure magic, and it has lasted all these years. Not the gum, but my memory of the magic. There was the fresh cut tree that Papa and my brother Herbert had brought in. So later, when I heard that Christmas tree farms had been planted, I thought that would be ideal, to be able to go out and choose our own Christmas tree from pretty much as had been done for my first Christmas.
It brings back memories of times that, you know, have kind of faded away because you're so concerned with the presents. And it kind of brings you back to that time, what it was like, because, you know, it's so real. You're seeing the actual scenes of what it was like at that time. Well, in some ways you almost wish you were back there. But you realize that's something in the past, and you say, wow, that was me then. Well, yeah. But I do remember how I looked then. But we normally don't think of those things because we're too concerned with today.
Part of the magic was waking up in the morning to a present that was unwrapped that Santa Claus had brought. And I don't know how much either one of you really believed in Santa Claus, but that was the magic part of having a gift left unwrapped. And then, of course, unlike when I was growing up, you had other gifts that you unwrapped. And there was fun in that.
that's kind of hard, because it's hard to put yourself back into your frame of mind of many, many years ago. You're the same person, and yet there's been so many changes that have taken place, and you have hopefully grown. But it's hard to recall exactly what your thoughts were at that time. I'm thinking, then I was thinking more about providing some sense of the magic of Christmas for the children, rather than, I wasn't really concerned about myself.
We come together at Christmas time, of course, for the fun and the anticipation of gifts and just the fun of being together. But I lost my thought.
I put Christmas's past in there, and that threw me off in the beginning. Why didn't you say Culver? That's wrong.
Well, you asked me, I don't know what you asked me earlier. I forgot now.
The first words I spoke in the original phonograph. Mary had a little lamb, its fleece was white as snow, and everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was sure to go.
What I hoped that each of you kids had gotten from Christmas, I would hope that you would continue to learn and to open up to the knowledge of life that is out there.
Evacuate the city as Martians approach.
Never to go to war with one another again.
This country is at war with Germany.
December 7th, 1941.
The Japanese have attacked Pearl Harbor.
A date which will live in infamy.
This is Bob, Command Performance Hulk, telling each Nazi that's in Russia today that Crimea doesn't pay.
I consider myself the luckiest man on the face of the earth.
There is much more to life than just the little giddy stuff of opening presents, and while that is great, but as you grow older and as you delve into interesting information, knowledge, you grow yourself.
Cocker Spaniel dog and our little girl Tricia, the six-year-old, named Chuck.
Are you a member of the Communist Party?
Oh, a cop, eh?
Or have you ever been a member of the Communist Party?
A giant caterpillar! A giant caterpillar!
A giant caterpillar! Baby, you're the greatest.
Applause for Sun Recording artist Elvis Presley.
I'd like to thank all those wonderful folks, and I'd like to thank you, too.
Three young seniors were killed today in the...